षष्ठोऽध्यायः ध्यानयोगः।
चैप्टर 6।
श्री भगवान उवाच, अनाश्रितः करं फलं कार्यं कर्म करोति यः, सा सन्यासी च योगी च ना निर्गनेर्ना चाक्रिया।
श्री भगवान सेड, Those who perform prescribed duties without desiring the results of their actions are actually sannyasis and yogis. Those who cease performing yajnas, such as the Agnihotra yajna, are not sannyasis. And those who merely abandon all bodily activities are not yogis.
Yam sannyasimiti prahur yogam tam vidhi pandava nahi sannyasata sankalpo योगी भवति कश्चन।
ओ अर्जुन, नो दैट व्हाट द वाइज कॉल निष्काम कर्म योगा इज नॉट डिफरेंट फ्रॉम कर्म संन्यास, बिकॉज वन हु इज अनेबल टू गिव अप द डिजायर फॉर द फ्रूट्स ऑफ एक्शंस एंड सेंस एंजॉयमेंट कैन नेवर बिकम अ योगी।
आरुरुक्षयो मनिर्योगम कर्म कारणम् उच्यते योगारूढस्य तस्यैव शमः कारणम् उच्यते।
फॉर अ सेज हु इज इंस्पायरिंग टू बिकम सिचुएटेड इन अनवेवरिंग ध्यान योग, निष्काम कर्म इज सेट टू बी द साधन, एंड व्हेन ही असेंड्स टू दैट स्टेज ऑफ योग कॉल्ड ध्यान निष्ठा, स्टेडीनेस इन मेडिटेशन, रिनाउंसिंग एक्शंस विच डिस्ट्रैक्ट हिज माइंड फ्रॉम ध्यान इज सेट टू बी द साधन।
यदा हीने इंद्रियार्थेषु न कर्म स्वनुषज्यते सर्वसंकल्प सन्यासी योगारूढस्तदुच्यते।
A tyagi who has become free from attachment to the sense objects and the performance of actions is called yogarudha, adept in yoga, for he has given up all desires for the fruits of his actions.
उद्धरेद आत्मा आत्मनम् न आत्मनाम अस्वादयेत आत्म एव हि आत्मनो बंधुरात्मा एव रिपुरात्मना।
वन मस्ट डिलीवर द सेल्फ बाय डिटैचिंग हिज माइंड फ्रॉम द मटेरियल वर्ल्ड एंड नॉट अलाउइंग इट टू डिग्रेड हिम, बिकॉज द माइंड कैन बी द फ्रेंड एंड ऑल्सो द एनिमी ऑफ द जीवात्मा।
बंधुरात्मा आत्मनस्तस्य येन आत्मा एव आत्मना जिता अनात्मनस्तु शत्रुत्वे वर्तते आत्मा एव शत्रुवत्।
फॉर वन हु हैज कॉन्कर्ड हिज माइंड इज हिज फ्रेंड, बट फॉर द जीवात्मा हु हैज नो कंट्रोल ओवर हिज माइंड इट वर्क्स अगेंस्ट हिम जस्ट लाइक एन एनिमी।
जितात्मनः प्रशांतस्य परमात्मा समाहितः शीतोष्ण सुख दुखेषु तथा मान अपमानयोः।
वन हुज माइंड इज कंट्रोल्ड इज फ्री फ्रॉम द डुअलिटीज ऑफ हीट एंड कोल्ड, हैप्पीनेस एंड मिजरी, ऑनर एंड डिसऑनर, अटैचमेंट एंड एनवी। द सोल ऑफ सच अ योगी इज डीपली एब्जॉर्ब्ड इन समाधि।
ज्ञान विज्ञान तृप्तात्मा कुटस्ततो विजेतेन्द्रियः युक्ता इति उच्यतो योगी समलोष्टश्म कांचनः।
A person whose mind is satisfied by jnana and vijnana, whose consciousness is unaffected by material transformation, who has conquered the senses, and who looks equally upon sand, stone and gold, is yogarudha, adept on the path of yoga.
सुरिन मित्रारि उदासीन मध्यस्थ द्वेषय बंधुषु साधुषु अपि च पापेषु समबुद्धिर् विशिष्यते।
वन हु लुक्स अपॉन वेल विशर्स फ्रेंड्स एनिमीज न्यूट्रल पीपल आर्बिट्रेटर्स एनवियस पीपल रिलेटिव्स सेंटली पर्सन्स एंड सिनर्स विद इक्वल विजन इज इवन मोर एक्सॉल्टेड।
योगी युञ्जित सततम् आत्मनम् रहसि स्थितः एकाकी यत् चित्तात्मा निराशेर अपरिग्रहः.
While residing alone in a solitary place, controlling his chitta, thoughts and body, devoid of desires and not accepting sense objects, a yogi should absorb his mind in samadhi.
Shucho deshe pratishthapya sthiram asanam atmanah nati ucharitam nati nicham chelajin kushottataram tatreka grahmanah kritva yat chetindriyah kriyah upavishyasane yunja yogam atma vishuddhaye.
In a sanctified place, one should make an asana by placing kusha grass, deer skin and then cloth on the ground. It should be neither too high nor too low. Sitting on that asana, one should practice yoga to purify the mind with one-pointed concentration and control all of his thoughts and activities.
Samamam kaya shiro grivam dharyanan achalam sthiraha samprekshaya nasikagram swam dishas chanavalokayan prasannatma vigat bhir brahmachari vrate sthitah manaha samyam mat chitto yukta asita mat parah.
Keeping one's body, neck and head erect and steady, one should fix one's vision solely on the tips of the nose. Thus, following strict celibacy, becoming fearless, peaceful and controlling the mind, one should practice yoga by meditating on me with one-pointed attention, remaining always devoted to me.
Yunjananam evam sada atmanam yogi niyata manasa shantim nirvanam paramam mat samstham adigacchati.
Thus, constantly keeping the mind absorbed in me through yoga, by following this process, a yogi whose mind is controlled can become situated in my sarup, nirvishesh brahm, and attain shanti in the form of complete emancipation.
Natyashanatastu yogosthiti nachekatmanashanatah nachati swapnashilasya jagrato naivacha arjuna.
O Arjun, yoga cannot be perfected by a person who eats too much or too little, or by one who sleeps too much or too little.
Yuktahara viharasya yukta cheshtayasya karmasu yukta swapanava bodhasya yogo bhavati dukkha.
For one who is moderate in eating and recreation, balanced in work and regulated in sleeping and wakefulness, his practice of yoga destroys all material miseries.
Yada viniyatam chittam atmani eva avitishtate nisriha sarva kamebhyo yukta iti uchyate tada.
When the mind becomes completely controlled and firmly fixed in the self alone, at that time one is said to be yukta, perfected in yoga, and is free from the craving for all sense enjoyment.
Yatha dipo nivatasthito ningato sopama smrita yogino yat chittasya yunjato yogam atmanah.
Just as a lamp in a windless place does not flicker, so a yogi whose chitta is controlled remains steady in his concentration on self-realization.
Yatro paramate chittam niruddham yoga sevaya yatra chevatman atmanam pashnanatmani tushyati sukham atyantikam yattat buddhi grajyamatindriyam veti yatra na chevaivam sthitasya chalati tatvatah. यम लब्ध्वा च परम लाभम मन्यते नाधिकं ततः यस्मिन् स्थितो न दुःखेन गुरुनापि विचलयते तं विद्याद् दुःख संयोग वियोगं योग संजनितं सा निश्चयेन योक्तव्यो योगानर्विन्नचेतसा संकल्प प्रभवान् काममस् त्वक्त्वा सर्वान् शेषतः मनसिन्द्रियाय ग्रामं विनियम्य समन्तता शनैः शनैरुपारामे बुद्ध्या धृति घृत्तया आत्मा संस्थां मनः कृत्वा न किञ्चिद् अभिचिन्तयेत्.
In that state of yoga called samadhi, the yogi's mind is controlled by the practice of yoga. He becomes detached from the sense objects and is satisfied within by realizing the self through that purified chitta, mind. In that state, the yogi experiences eternal bliss through his transcendental intelligence, which is beyond the realm of the senses. Being thus established, he never deviates from his Atma Swarupa, intrinsic nature, and upon attaining Atma Sukha, the bliss of the self, he considers there to be no greater acquisition. When he is situated on that platform, he does not become perturbed even by the greatest of miseries. Know that state to be devoid of any contact with the duality of mundane happiness and misery. This yoga should be performed with full patience of mind, having completely given up all whimsical desires, and with the mind controlling the senses from all directions. One should follow the instructions of Shastras and Sadhu with determination. One should make his intelligence resolute and determined, and should gradually become detached by establishing the mind in the self and by not thinking of anything else.
Yato yato nischalati manascha chanchalam asthiram tatastato niyamayeta atmani eva vasham naye.
No matter how the restless and unsteady mind wanders to the various sense objects, it should be restrained and fixed within the self alone.
Prashanta manasam hiyenam yoginam sukham uttamam upeti shanta rajasam brahma bhutama kalmasham.
Such a peaceful yogi who sees everything in connection with Brahm and who is free from rajagun and the reactions of past sins attains supreme bliss in the form of self-realization.
Yunjananam evam sada atmanam yogi vigat kalmashah sukhena brahm samsparsham atyantam sukham ashnute.
In this way, by continuous practice, a sinless yogi makes the self-study in yoga and easily attains supreme bliss in the form of Brahm realization, becoming liberated from material life.
Sarvabhutastham atmanam sarvabhutani cha atmani ikshayate yoga yuktatma sarvatra samudarshanah.
A person who is linked in yoga realizes Brahm everywhere. He observes him as Paramatma, who is situated in all living entities, and observes all living entities in him.
Yo mam pashyati sarvatra sarvancha mayi pashyati tasyaham na pranashyami sachame na pranashyati.
For one who sees me in all beings and sees all beings in me, I am never lost, nor is he ever lost to me.
Sarvabhuta sthitam yo mam bhajate katvama sthitah sarvatha vartamano api sa yogi mayi vartate.
The yogi who worships me, the all-pervading super soul, with one point in intelligence in both the sadhan and siddha stage, considering me to be the supreme absolute reality without the second, dwells only in me in all circumstances.
Atmopam yena sarvatra samamam pashyati yo Arjuna sukham va yadi va dukham sa yogi paramo matah.
O Arjun, he who through self-realization sees all jivas as equal to himself and who considers their pleasure and pain to be his own is the best yogi. That is my opinion.
Arjuna vachah yo ayam yogas tvaya prokta samyena madhusudana etasyam na pashyami chanchalatavat sthitam sthiram.
Arjun said, O Madhusudan, the yoga prescribed by you that is based on equanimity towards everyone, everywhere, seems to be impermanent due to the restless nature of my mind.
Chanchalam hi manaha Krishna pramathi balavat dridam tasyaham nikraham manne vayur eva sudushkaram.
O Krishna, the mind is by nature restless, powerful, obstinate and capable of completely overpowering the intelligence, body and senses. It seems as difficult to control as the wind.
Shri Bhagavanu Vachaha Asanshayam Mahabaho Manodurnigraham Chalam Abhyasena Tu Kaunteya Vairagyenancha Grihyate.
Shri Bhagavan said, O Mahabahu, undoubtedly the mind is restless and hard to control. Yet, by abhyas, constant practice and vairagya, true renunciation, it can be controlled, O Kaunteya.
Asanyatmana yogo dushprape iti me matihi vashyatmana tu yatata shakyavapatum upayatah.
It is very difficult for one whose mind is not controlled to achieve self-realization through this yoga system. However, one who has brought his mind under control and who strives by the proper means of abhyas and vairagya can attain perfection in yoga. This is my opinion.
Arjuna vachah ayatihi shadhyayopeto yoga chalita manasah aprapya yoga samsiddhim kamagatim krishna gachati.
Arjun asks, O Krishna, what is the destination of one who begins the process of yoga with faith but later, due to an uncontrolled mind, falls back into the worldliness and fails to attain perfection in yoga?
Kachinno bhayam vibhrashtas chinnabhram eva nashyati apartishto mahabaho vimudo brahmanah pathi.
O Mahabaho Krishna, if one falls from the process of karma and yoga and becomes deviated from the path of attaining Brahm, does he not perish like a riven cloud with no shelter anywhere?
Itanme samshayam Krishna chetitum arhyasi asheshatah twadanne samshayasya chetah nahi upapadaye.
O Krishna, this is my doubt and I implore you to remove it completely. Other than you, no one else can possibly dispel this doubt.
Shri Bhagavan Vachah Partha Naiveva Namutra Vinashas Tasya Vidhayate Nahi Kalyanu Kritam Kasche Durgatim Tat Gachati.
Shri Bhagavan said, O Partha, such an unsuccessful yogi is not lost in this world nor the next, because, my dear friend, a person who is engaged in auspicious acts never attains an unfavorable destination.
Prapya punya kritam loka उषित्वा शाश्वतिः समः शुचीनां श्रीमतां गेहे योगभ्रष्टो विजायते.
One who deviates from the path of yoga after practicing for only a short time attains the planets of the pious and after enjoying there for many years takes birth in a righteous and wealthy family.
Athva yogi namiva kule bhavati dhimatam etadhi durlabataram loke janma yadi drisham.
The yogi who deviates after practicing for a long time takes his birth in the home of a yogi who are great in wisdom. Such a birth is undoubtedly very rare in this world.
Tatratam buddhi samyogam labate parva dehikam yatate cha tato bhuyah samsiddho kuru nandanan.
O Kuru Nandana, that unsuccessful yogi regains the divine consciousness of his previous birth that is related to Paramatma, and he again endeavors to attain perfection in yoga.
Purvabhyasena teneva hriyate hi avasho api saha jigyasur api yogasya shabda brahmati vartate.
By virtue of his previous practice, he is automatically attracted to the path of moksha, and after inquiring a little about yoga, he transcends the path of sakam karma described in the Vedas.
Paryatnad yatmanastu yogi samshudha kilbisha anek janma samsiddhi tato yati paramagatim.
However, the yogi who practices sincerely is free from all sins after many births and ultimately becomes perfect. Thus he attains the supreme destination.
Tapasvi bhayo adhiko yogi jnani bhayo api matodhikah karma bhischa adhiko yogi tasmada yogi bhav arjuna.
The yogi is considered superior to the tapasvi, ascetic, the jnani and the karmi. Therefore, O Arjun, be a yogi.
Yogi nam api sarvesham madgate nanantaratmana shaddhavan bhajate yomam seme yukta tamomatah.
He who constantly performs my bhajan with full faith, always thinking exclusively of me within himself, is in my opinion the topmost of all yogis.
Iti Shriman Bhagavad Gita Su Upanishad Su Brahma Vidyayam Yoga Shastre Shri Krishna Arjun Samvade Dhyana Yogo Nama Shashto Adhyayah.